Tell the people in the back to make sure they have their whispers on real quick. Or get a thumbs up or something. Bob Goats, can you hear me, sir? I see you. See, I knew somebody didn't have their whisper on.
I had mine on.
Look at that. Good? Okay. So, just to remind you guys, you're going to read through the scriptures and you're going to see some names like Gergesene and Gadarene and things of that nature. A few different English, at least, translations of where this event took place. This is the only possible place of all of the theoretical places of this miracle that it could have happened because of the proximity to the Sea of Galilee. And when you're thinking about this happening right here in this spot and seeing the pigs actually go over this cliff, you'll notice that that doesn't put them in the water. And that's because literally the Sea of Galilee has been drained to such a degree that the water used to be right here. So it would have been directly into the water if you went over a cliff like this. So, and that gives you quite a visual of how much deeper that the Sea of Galilee used to be. So just a quick reminder, there's a whole lot in this event, in this miracle, definitely a whole lot that I don't know, but the one thing that I took away from it was the irony isn't lost on anybody who was paying attention, that this was also the region of the 10th Roman Legion. And I apologize when I told that story on the boat in the Sea of Galilee, I sent everybody a picture of that crest or that symbol that they would wear, but I hit the wrong Telegram group. And so I just sent it to my wife. And when she woke up a few hours later, she texted me back like, "What is this picture of this pig?" And I was like, "Oh gosh, she wasn't here for that." But I sent it to y'all later that night. So hopefully you got it. But that was the symbol and that was the crest of the 10th Roman Legion. And so their symbol was pigs. And the battalion that stayed here was a battalion estimated of 2,000 men, which means that soldiers come and go, things happen. So it might not have been exactly 2,000, but the estimated size of the battalion was 2,000. And the number of the pigs was 2,000. And the symbol of the battalion was the pig. So as all of the Jewish, or many of the Jewish consort were expecting a Messiah who was going to overthrow their enemies, which were the Romans, he came for a different reason, to help you overthrow yourself, the true enemy, right? And deliver you from your sin nature, not from your taxation. But he showed at the same time, if I wanted to overthrow the Romans, it would be this easy. And so he took their symbol, all the demons of Legion, into that symbol, which Legion of Battalion, very similar word. And then off they go into the sea. And then my broader point, if you remember, was now, and it's easier to connect now, so check this out. I know I'm retelling a story, but it's going to be a little different now, that you just came from Bethsaida. So if you read the story of going into the other side after the feeding of the 5,000, he tells them to get into a boat and go to the other side, but he tells them specifically, go to Bethsaida. So then the storm comes up and he begins walking on the water, which means so the water would be somewhere between here and where we just were in Bethsaida, right? So it's actually very close proximity that the water he was walking on also contained the carcasses of the pigs that represented the enemies of the Jewish people and were full of the true enemies, which is the demonic. So a very much treading on your enemies moment when he was walking on the water, which is to say, it was a powerful statement. Jesus will find you, meet you where you're at, even if he has to walk on water. But not only if he has to walk on water, but he'll tread right on the heads of your enemies to get to where you're at, right? And help you to drown your enemies and see his glory. So anyway, we already told the story on the boat, so just wanted to remind you and reiterate. But pretty awesome spot, huh? God is good. So take about 45 minutes and explore this little circle right here, these 17 rocks, and then we'll get ready to go to the Jordan.